Hi, I'm Richard from Electric Classic Cars, and on this week's episode, we're going to be looking at the benefits of EV-specific tyres. And to do that, I'm not going to be using my classic VW over here. I've been loaned a modern VW over here, so I'm a little bit excited to drive that, because it's not often I get to drive modern cars. But first of all, what are EV tyres? Let's have a chat about that. Now, since the mass adoption of electric vehicles, the boffins at the R&D departments of the tyre companies have had to get busy designing and building tyres that match the characteristics, if you like, of an electric vehicle. For instance, EVs can be a little bit heavier than an ICE vehicle. They've certainly got a lot more power and torque, so the acceleration can be more aggressive. But also, an electric vehicle can be a lot quieter, obviously, than a petrol or diesel car. So the customer's requirements might be, oh, what about a tyre that's quieter? Let's go for that with my electric vehicle. Or what about a tyre that's got less rolling resistance, so my range is going to be a lot more. So electric vehicle specific tyres have become a thing lately, and that's what we're going to do in this episode. We're going to be comparing the tyres that are on the vehicle, which are Continental Ultra Connect NXTs, to these Hankook iONGT tyres, both of which are EV specific tyres. Now, it's fair to say tyre technology has come on a long way since this beautiful carbon gear first came out, and these Hankook tyres are at the cutting edge of that technology. What I've got in front of me here is the Hankook iONGT, and Hankook are actually the first company to bring out a complete range of tyres specifically for EVs, everything from sports cars to SUVs. They've even got winter and ice tyres for EVs as well. Now, Hankook have been involved in Formula E since 2022, and their technology that they've learned from that series is in these ION tyres, and this one here is a triple A rated tyre, which means it's rated A for rolling resistance, A for noise, and A for wet grip, and it doesn't get much better than that. Now, no doubt there's a lot of technology they put into this tyre based off that experience with Formula E, but there's a few that really start to get me excited. Things like their mantra of charge less, cruise more. I love that. So they've got something called ICE super mileage technology put into this, which means that they concentrate, for instance, on tread wear and extending the life of the tyres, but at the same time reducing the rolling resistance of the tyre so that it goes further on a charge. Driving my electric classics, sound is a big thing for me, or lack of, if you like, because the engine's not there anymore, so what you end up hearing is wind and tyre noise. And Hankook have put a lot of time and effort into developing this tyre to be quiet, to match the quietness of an electric vehicle. And some of it, like the patented corn husk technology in between the treads here, apparently makes a big difference. To match the greener credentials of electric vehicles, Hankook have developed the iONGT tyres to have the highest level of sustainable materials in the marketplace. They've got 77% sustainable products in these tyres, compared to an industry standard of around about 27%. So these features are all well and good, but I'm not here to talk about features. I'm here to do a road test. What I want to do is do exactly the same journey with the tyres that this car came on, which are the Continental Ultra Connect NXTs, and then do the same journey with the Hankooks on. So I'm going to be looking at things like, you know, what the noise is like, what the handling's like, and more importantly for me, what's the efficiency like? What's that kilowatt hour per mile figure like? So let's get going. To do this tyre comparison in the most scientific way, what we're going to do is we're going to do the same trip twice, exactly the same. It's going around about 100 miles, we reckon. We're going to drive it in the same way, try to keep the average speed the same. I've got it in eco mode. We're going to make sure that the tyre pressures are the same, so everything, as much as we can control, is the same. And as I say, what we're going to be looking at specifically is, can I notice any difference on noise, grip on these lovely twisty roads in Wales, which is very important for where we are. And most importantly, as I said before, is the efficiency. So I'm keeping an eye on
miles per kilowatt hour, which is on the dashboard here. I want to see if there's any differences or any noticeable difference. We're coming up to the first kind of twisty section that I quite like to put my foot down on. And don't forget, I've got the Continental NXTs on now. So I'm just going to see what these are like through this S section. Pretty good. Yeah, not bad. No tyre squeal.
Tim planted, aren't they?
Tim's gone quiet, which means that, yeah, not that bad. We've got a straight here, so I'm going to do 50 miles an hour. Keep it at 50. I just see what the sound's like.
It's quiet. That noise test, yeah.
Pretty quiet.
That is pretty quiet.
But is it because of the car or the tyres? Or probably both, I suppose.
They're both.
Compared to a classic car, it's almost silent. There's no squeaks or rattles. Right, we're just about coming to the end of the test of the Continental Ultra Connect NXTs. We've done 96 miles. Just click then. 96 miles, and it is an efficiency of 3.4 miles per kilowatt hour. Make a note of that.
Yeah, got that? Yeah, I'll write that down.
3.4 miles per kilowatt hour, 96 miles. So we quickly got to put the Hankook tyres in the back.
Yeah.
Get them to the tyre place before it shuts and do exactly the same thing. And I'm going to put this on charge as well. Just to try and get it back up to about the same state of charge as it was before.
Yeah, good idea.
Can you believe I've got four tyres in the boot of this ID3? It's a decent sized boot, you know. Yeah. Right, let's see what these Hankook iONGTs are like then.
Yeah, the next 100 mile, here we go.
Don't sound so excited.
So what do you think about the ID3 then?
Tell you what, it's a bit luxurious, isn't it? I'm not used to this. Most of my cars I drive are, you know, 1960s and 70s. There's one feature I do think is really cool. You see the pedals?
Oh yeah, they've got,
yeah. There's a pause icon for the brake and a play icon for the accelerator. I think that's pretty cool. Tell you what, the cornering ability of these Hankook tyres is probably the most impressive thing for me so far. They're noticeably better than the Continentals.
Yeah.
To me, they feel like a lower profile tyre. That's, you know, that's the only way I can describe it. So every time I'm going to a corner like this, they're sharper. If you know what I mean, more precise.
Well, do you want to hear the Hankook?
Oh, Tim's tech corner.
Yeah, tech corner. Because I've got all the gumph in front of me, and it tells me it's because of the pro grip compound, which enhances grip on wet surfaces, which it's doing. Yeah.
I tell you what, that's not just marketing hype,
yeah.
That's actually true.
And it's grip boost technology improves handling performance by increasing cornering stiffness by 10%. Right. So you're saying you think you're getting that then?
Yeah.
Cool.
If you hold on now, I'll put it to the test. You ready?
I'm holding on.
That's pretty good. See, I would expect a car normally to wash out there, understeer a little bit on that corner, because it's down. And it's a tight corner, and it's wet,
yeah.
And it just gripped. One thing that caught my eye when I was reading up on the bump on these Hankook iONGT tyres is the fact that they're lighter. There's like an extreme lightness feature that they've got in these tyres. I can't remember the percentage, maybe we'll put up on the screen.
So that improves your unsprung weight.
Performance-wise,
yeah.
That's no bad thing.
No, because if you save a bit of weight on your wheels,
yeah,
it's a huge improvement overall.
Definitely. coming up to that straight again now where we did the sound test before. So if I go up to the same speed, and okay, what do you reckon? It's hard to say without a decibel meter.
It's hard to say. It's definitely not any noisier, is it?
Definitely not. No. I mean, they're both really, really quiet, I'd say. All right. That is 200 miles, well, nearly 200 miles done in a day. So, back to where we started again. 96 miles done again.
Yeah.
So that's pretty accurate. 3.6 miles per kilowatt hour. Can you remember what the Continentals were?
3.4.
So 3.4 miles per kilowatt hour for the Continental NXTs and 3.6 miles per kilowatt hour for the Hankook iONGTs. I'll have to work out what the percentage is because I can't do that in my head. But yeah, I think that's a clear win on efficiency for the Hankook.
Yeah, that's for sure. Pretty good, isn't it?
So there we go, that is 200 miles done in a VW ID3, 100 miles with the Continental Ultra Connect NXTs, and 100 miles done with the Hankook iONGTs. And result wise, I mean, I was looking at three things today. Noise, which is really difficult to try to get a conclusion on because both tyres are really quiet. I mean, if you're going to do it scientifically, you would need a decibel meter in the car, but I couldn't tell any difference. Could you, Tim?
No, but the tyres were definitely quieter than the tyres you get on a petrol car, aren't they?
Yeah, and certainly...
Or on a non-specific EV tyre.
Certainly quieter than a classic car that's electric as well, because you've got wind noise there, you've got road noise. And so both tyres, big tick. Very, very quiet, but anything more than that, we'd have to get, you know, some instrumentation out to do it. Performance-wise, I definitely like the Hankook tyres there. Certainly when I was starting to lean on the corners a little bit more and get a bit more sporty, I felt more confidence with the Hankook tyres. They just felt sharper. But it was the range or the efficiency that got me and surprised me, because I was, you know, if anything, it was going to be maybe 1%, 2% in it. I didn't expect 5% difference, if I'm honest. And bear in mind, we're not comparing, you know, tyres that are off-road tyres to really efficient tyres here. We're comparing two efficient tyres. So to get a 5% difference, that was surprising. So for the Hankook iONGTs to be 5% more efficient than the other tyres, the Continentals, was surprising. But I just want to put a caveat in here because we were getting, what was it, 3.6 kilowatt hours per mile?
3.6 was the best.
3.6 miles per kilowatt hour. And I know there's people out there probably got VW IDs and they're saying, oh, well, I get 4 or 4.5 or I only get 3. Bear in mind, that efficiency was for the journey that we did today, which is up through the mountains, a bit of spirited driving as well to test the performance of the tyres. So there will be differences between people out there that have got these that have different efficiency measures or results, if you like. But, you know, overall, really like the car. It's come at quite an apt time. Thank you, Volkswagen, for lending us this car, because more importantly, Tim's wife is considering a new car, and I think they're going to borrow this car tomorrow and go for a little bit of a family drive.
It's an impressive car. It's a nice car.
You like it, didn't you?
A comfy car, yeah.
I'm still going to stick with my classics, people, so don't worry about that. I'm not being persuaded to go over to the dark so I can get modern cars, but, you know, as a modern car, I enjoyed it today. But I think if anybody out there is considering new tyres for electric vehicle, definitely get some electric vehicle specific tyres, because the attributes of those tyres perfectly match the features that come with the electric vehicles itself. You know, the rolling resistance is less, they're quieter, you know, all the other benefits, if you like, of those tyres perfectly match an electric vehicle. So, and I would definitely recommend the Hankook iONGTs after today, and we'll put a link in the description for you to go and find out where to find those tyres. So on that note, I hope you enjoyed this episode and found it interesting, and we'll see you on the next one.